Hello students, today we will start chapter 1 which is electric charges and field. So before we move on to this chapter, let us see introduction or what we are going to study in this chapter. We will start from our common observation. What is our common observation? That when we remove our synthetic cloth or sweater, we see a spark or hear a crackle sound or hear a crackle sound. So this is one observation, that whenever you try to remove your synthetic cloth or sweater, suddenly you can sometimes see a spark or you can hear a crackle sound. Now why this thing happen? It happens because of the discharge of electric charge. Discharge of an electric charge from our body, which are accumulated due to rubbing of insulating surfaces. So whenever we rub the insulating surface, some of our electric charge from our body get discharged, or in fact we say it move from one substance to our body. So we see a spark or hear a crackle sound. This is one observation. Another observation is lightning in the sky. Now you have might seen a lightning in the sky during the rainy season. Now why or how this lightning in the sky take place? Again, it is due to discharge of electric charge. Though we will study what is an electric charge in detail, but all these phenomena or observations are due to the discharge of electric charge. Now this discharge of electric charge take place from cloud to the atmosphere. So these are two common observations or the natural phenomenon. Lightning in the sky is a natural phenomenon. So both the examples are related with the discharge of electric charge. Now this branch of physics which you are going to study is called static electricity. So chapter 1 is a static electricity, or sometime we also refer to this branch as frictional electricity, because most of the observation in the chapters are due to the rubbing of two different substances. So we know when we rub the things, the heat is generated due to friction. So this branch or chapter 1 deals with the static electricity or frictional electricity. Now we know the static means at rest or which cannot move. So this branch of physics is nothing but a study of electric charges. It is the study of electric charges at rest. So in this chapter we will study what are the electric charges, but you have to remember the charges will be static or rest. They will not move from one point to the another. Yes, but they can be transferred from one body to the another, because we have to drop the things. Similarly, after studying about the electric charges,
we will also study about the electric force.
So the force between the charges, the force between the electric charges will be named as electric force.
The electric charges give rise to electric field.
So we will also study about the electric field.
And in second chapter, this is the first chapter, electric force and electric field. And second chapter, we will study about electric potential.
So this is what we are going to discuss in chapter 1,
and electric potential will be our chapter 2.
And we will now try to define what is an electric charge. So the first topic of our chapter is electric charge. So let us start our topic, electric charge. Now before we define what is an electric charge, let us see what the history says about the electric charges. So historically, the discovery of different observations, regarding electric charge
historically,
the discovery of the different observations which we will see regarding electric charge is given to Thales of Miletus, who was the scientist of Greece. Now, what was his first observation regarding the electric charge? So, the first observation was when an ember, so an ember is a yellow resinic substance, and this ember was found near the seashore of Greece. So this ember substance, which is a yellow resinic substance, was rubbed. So we rubbed it with a wool, and after rubbing, it was found that both ember as well as wool attracts piece of paper or lighter objects like polystyrene. So lighter object like pith ball, or we can say a polystyrene material, it is a substance from which the balls can be made. Generally we refer it as a pith ball. So these two substances, when they were rubbed, they started attracting piece of paper or lighter objects like pith ball. Now ember itself means, in Greece or Greek, ember itself means electron, and from this the word electricity originated. So this is historic description of electric charges. So it all started with a rubbing of an ember substance with a wool, which was attracting the piece of papers or any lighter object. Later on, many pair of substances were seen attracting the lighter object. Another observation was a glass rod was again rubbed with the silk cloth, and after rubbing again both attracts lighter objects. So this is one pair of substances, like amber and wool, similarly glass rod rubbed with silk. Then another observation was the plastic rod was rubbed with fur. So same observation, they also attract the lighter objects. Now further observations were made regarding the glass rod or plastic rod. Now let us see one glass rod which is rubbed with a silk is hemmed by nylon thread. So this glass rod is already rubbed with a silk cloth or a wool. Now it was found, later on we will discuss how this glass rod becomes a positively charged. So let us assume after rubbing the glass rod becomes positively charged. Now when a plastic rod which is, now let us say a plastic rod which is rubbed by the fur, it was rubbed by fur. We assume the plastic rod becomes negative charge. Now when this plastic rod was brought near to the glass rod, this is our glass rod, we find that there is a force of attraction of the glass rod towards the plastic rod. Though we are assuming glass rod becomes positive charge, plastic rod becomes negatively charged. How they becomes charged, or why it becomes positive charge and why it becomes negative charge, that we will discuss. For the time being, let us assume glass rod is positively charged and plastic rod is negatively charged. So you will see a force of attraction. Similarly, if the two glass rods which are rubbed with a silk or wool, so this is a glass rod, it is rubbed with a wool or silk, again we assume the glass rod becomes positive charge. Now another glass rod rubbed with silk, it becomes positively charged. So there are two glass rods. It was found that the glass rod which was hanged is ripple, or you will observe a repulsion between the two glass rods. So when the glass rod was brought near to the plastic rod, there was a force of attraction. Glass rod brought near to the glass rod which are rubbed with a silk cloth, you will find a repulsion. Instead of two glass rod, if we bring two plastic rod near to each other, they also are found to be repelling each other. So this were the observations were made initially by different substances. Many such pair of substances when rubbed attract the piece of paper or a lighter objects. So this indicates that the charge on glass rod should be opposite to the plastic rod, and if there is a repulsion, both the bodies should have same charges. Now this we call it a polarity. So what is polarity? Polarity is a property which differentiate two types of charges. So the property which differentiate two types of charges is called polarity. So we can say that, example, a glass rod polarity is opposite to that of plastic rod. So we will be using the word polarity. So the property which differentiate two types of charges. Now, from this observation, we have two types of charges, the positive charge and the negative charge. So we will be referring this as a polarity. So glass rod polarity is positive, or you can say plastic rod polarity is negative, or the polarity of the glass rod and the plastic rod is opposite. So after this observations, here the body is charged due to rubbing. So the first observations which we made is two bodies can be charged by rubbing against each other, and by rubbing the two bodies a heat is generated, and later on we will see it is a transfer of electron from one body to the another. So we will see that the electron get transferred from one body to another. As a result, both the bodies which are rubbed together are said to be electrified. And because the body are being electrified, the body is electrified by rubbing. So this method is called as charging by friction. So the body, all the bodies found in nature are almost or are generally neutral. We cannot find a charged body in the nature. So if we want to electrify a body, or if you want to charge a body, one method, this is our first method. So charging by friction means simply rub the two different substances. And when we rub two different substances, say glass rod with a silk cloth or a wool. So if glass rod becomes positively charged, the silk cloth becomes negative charged. And similarly, if we take plastic rod with a fur, you are rubbing these two substances, then plastic rod becomes negative charged and fur becomes positive charged. And you will observe the glass rod will be attracted towards plastic rod, silk cloth will be attracted towards fur, fur will repel glass rod, plastic rod will repel silk cloth. So we say their polarities are opposite. So one method to charge a body is charging by friction. Another method to charge, so we have a second method which is called charging by conduction. Charging by conduction. So first method was, if you want to charge a body, just simply rub it, and due to heat generated, the electrons will be transferred from one body to the other. We will discuss this in detail in the second lecture. The second method to charge a body is charging by conduction. Again, we will start from our observations. Now, two pith ball, and nowadays we can take a polystring ball or insulated thermocol ball. So, these are two pith ball. They are hanged by a nylon thread. Now let us see what is the observation. A glass rod is rubbed with a silk cloth. So when you rub a glass rod with a silk cloth, the glass rod, as we discussed before, becomes positive charge. How it becomes positive charge, that we will discuss in the second lecture. And silk cloth becomes negative charge, that also we will discuss. However, after rubbing glass rod with the silk cloth, the glass rod becomes positively charged. Now, if you touch this charged glass rod, we assume the glass rod is positively charged, to one of the pith wall, and another glass rod, which is also rubbed with the silk cloth, again glass rod becomes positive. It is also touched to the second pith ball. What we will observe, the pith ball will become, both the pith ball will become positive charge, and you will see a repulsion between them. So repulsion is being observed between the two pith wall. Now because we are touching this glass rod with the pith wall, we say the pith wall is charged by a method called charging by convection. Initially pith wall were neutral, but after touching it with the glass rod, we observe there is a force of repulsion. So when you charge any uncharged body by making a contact, we call it charging by conduction. So here pith wall is positively charged, both are positively charged because they were touched with glass rod. How this thing happens, that is a discussion which we will be discussing in detail. Today we are discussing only about the observations made by different scientists. So how it becomes positive charge, how silk cloth becomes negative charge, ये सब कैसे होता है, क्यों हो रहा है, उन सब के जवाब हमें धीरे धीरे मिलते जाएंगे. अभी आप हम सिर्फ ऑब्जर्वेशन कर रहे हैं. सो अभी हमने मैं नहीं बता सकता हूं कि भाई ग्लास रॉड क्यों पॉजिटिव चार्ज हुआ है. We will discuss. However, because we have touched a body, we will refer it back charging by convection. तो अगर कोई अनचार्ज्ड बॉडी किसी चार्ज बॉडी के साथ टच करे जाए, तो अनचार्ज बॉडी भी चार्ज की जा सकती है, और इस मेथड ऑफ चार्जिंग को कहते हैं चार्जिंग बाय कंडक्शन. नाउ लेट अस रिमूव द ग्लास रॉड. ग्लास रॉड हटा के प्लास्टिक रॉड हमने किससे रब किया था, फर के साथ, एंड वी एज्यूम किया था प्लास्टिक रॉड बिकम्स नेगेटिव चार्ज. अब दो नेगेटिवली चार्ज प्लास्टिक रॉड दो पिच बॉल को टच कर, तो ये जो पिथ वॉल न्यूट्रल थे वो दोनों भी नेगेटिव हो जाते हैं, और अगेन आवर ऑब्जर्वेशन इज रिपल्शन. सो अगेन इफ यू टच अ प्लास्टिक रॉड टू द न्यूट्रल पिथ वॉल बिकम्स नेगेटिवली चार्ज एंड यू विल ऑब्जर्व अ रिपल्शन. द थर्ड ऑब्जर्वेशन व्हिच इज अपोजिट टू दैट, वन ऑफ द पिथ वॉल इज टच्ड विद अ ग्लास रॉड इज पॉजिटिवली चार्ज. And another pith wall is touched with the plastic rod, which is negatively charged. Now what will happen? The pith wall, which is touched with the glass rod, becomes positive charge. And the pith wall, which is touched with the plastic rod, becomes negative charge. And now instead of repulsion, we will see both the pith wall are attracted towards each other. So in this method we will also take another example for charging by conduction. So in this method, if we want to define what is charging by conduction, then charging by conduction is the process in which an uncharged body is charged by making physical contact. So the process in which an uncharged body is charged by making physical contact with charged body is called charging by conduction. तो इसको कहते हैं charging by conduction. टच करना पड़ेगा कोई भी अनचार्ज बॉडी के साथ, you have to make a physical contact with the charged body. और अपनी जो न्यूट्रल बॉडी है या अनचार्ज बॉडी है वो क्या हो जाती है, चार्ज हो जाती है. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड चार्जिंग बाय कंडक्शन. सो देर आर two methods which we have discussed. One is charging by conduction, one is which we have discussed previously, charging by friction. Friction mein dono body ko physically touch karna padega and you have to rub it. conduction will know away. But in conduction method, you have to bring any charged body. A charged body लेके आना पड़ेगा और neutral body को touch करके रखना है. So this that will be called as charging by conduction. The third method, which we will discuss later on, charging by induction. So तीसरा method होता है charging by induction. ये भी एक बहुत इंटरेस्टिंग मेथड है टू चार्ज अ बॉडी. सो यहां पे रब करना है, यहां दो बॉडी को फिजिकली टच करना है. इंडक्शन में नो टचिंग नो रबिंग, बट यू नीड वन चार्ज बॉडी. तो जैसे कंडक्शन में भी एक चार्ज बॉडी तो चाहिए था मुझे, गिलास थोड़ा चार्ज होगा तो मैं आपके उस फिफ्थ वॉल को टच करूंगा. सिमिलरली चार्जिंग बाय इंडक्शन में भी मुझे चार्ज ग्लास रॉड या प्लास्टिक रॉड या कोई चार्ज सब्सटेंस की जरूरत है, पर ना मैं रब करूंगा ना मैं टच करूंगा, एंड विदाउट टचिंग द बॉडी विल बी चार्ज. जो न्यूट्रल बॉडी है वो चार्ज हो जाएगी, एंड वी विल कॉल दैट मेथड एज चार्जिंग बाय इंडक्शन. ये मेथड हम दो तीन लेक्चर के बाद डिस्कस करेंगे, क्योंकि अभी हम सिर्फ ऑब्जर्वेशंस पढ़ रहे हैं. बहुत सारे क्वेश्चंस अनआंसर्ड है. फॉर एग्जांपल टॉपिक का नाम दे दिया इलेक्ट्रिक चार्ज, लेकिन अभी तक मैं डिफाइन नहीं कर रहा हूं व्हाट इज इलेक्ट्रिक चार्ज. अभी तो मैं सिर्फ यही बता रहा हूं कि एक बॉडी चार्ज हो जाए, एक बॉडी पॉजिटिव चार्ज होती है, एक बॉडी नेगेटिव चार्ज. सो आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट द टाइप ऑफ चार्जेस, नॉट व्हाट इज इलेक्ट्रिक चार्ज इटसेल्फ. दैट वी विल डिस्कस. Now all these observations are summed up. अब अपने conclude करते हैं. What was our first conclusion? कि polarity of glass rod. So I am concluding the thing. When repulsion attraction was seen between different objects, we say the polarity of glass rod is opposite to प्लास्टिक. सो ग्लास रॉड और प्लास्टिक रॉड की पोलैरिटी अपोजिट होती है. और इस ऑब्जर्वेशन से या इस कंक्लूजन से वी हैव फाइंड बाय द ऑब्जर्वेशंस ऑफ पिथ बॉल के अनलाइक चार्ज अट्रैक्ट करते हैं एंड लाइक चार्ज रिपल करते हैं. और हमारे पास कितने टाइप्स के चार्ज हो गए? देयर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ चार्जेस. नंबर वन पॉजिटिव चार्ज एंड नंबर टू वी हैव नेगेटिव चार्ज. दो आई हैव नॉट डिफाइंड व्हाट इज इलेक्ट्रिक चार्ज, अभी भी इसका डेफिनेशन बाकी है. सो ऑब्जर्वेशंस इंडिकेट कि दो टाइप के चार्ज पॉसिबल हैं, वन इज पॉजिटिव चार्ज वन इज नेगेटिव चार्ज. इफ देयर आर टू पॉजिटिव चार्जेस तो दे विल रिपल इच अदर, ये हमें पता है. एक पॉजिटिव चार्ज है एक नेगेटिव है तो अट्रैक्शन होगा, दोनों नेगेटिव है तो भी रिपल्शन होगा. सो दिस वाज़ द ऑब्जर्वेशन. नाउ हु नेम्ड दिस टाइप ऑफ चार्जेस, पॉजिटिव चार्ज नेगेटिव चार्ज, वर्ड कहां से आया? सो दिस वर्ड वर कॉइन्ड बाय बेंजामिन फ्रैंकलिन. तो बेंजामिन फ्रैंकलिन इसने इस नामकरण किया या पॉजिटिव चार्ज नेगेटिव चार्ज बोला, क्यों बोला और क्या किस ऑब्जर्वेशन से बोला? हाउ ही नेम द चार्जेस एज पॉजिटिव चार्ज एंड नेगेटिव चार्ज. नाउ वी नो इफ आई टेक अ रियल नंबर 3 एंड अनदर रियल नंबर -3, एक प्लस रियल नंबर 3 एक माइनस, और मैं इनका समेशन करता हूं तो आई विल गेट 0 आंसर. इन अदर वर्ड I can say both the number has nullified themselves. दोनों एक दूसरे के अपोजिट है तो आंसर क्या आता है? 0. तो शायद बेंजामिन फ्रैंकलिन का यही लॉजिक रहा होगा, क्योंकि जब हमने गिलास रॉड को, गिलास रॉड एज्यूम कर लेते हैं पॉजिटिव चार्ज हो गया है और सिल्क क्लॉथ नेगेटिव चार्ज हो गया, सो दिस इज अ सिल्क क्लॉथ, गिलास रॉड रब किया चार्जिंग बाय फ्रिक्शन, गिलास रॉड पॉजिटिव बन गया, सिल्क क्लॉथ नेगेटिव। अब इस गिलास रॉड को, सो दिस इज गिलास रॉड, मेरी हैंडराइटिंग और डायग्राम तुम लोगों से बहुत खराब है, ठीक है, तो उसके लिए माफी चाहता हूं। सो दिस इज अ गिलास रॉड। नाउ इफ आई टच दिस गिलास रॉड विद अ सिल्क क्लॉथ, इन दोनों को रब करते हैं, सॉरी टच करता है, और टच करने के बाद व्हेन दे आर सेपरेटेड अगेन, अब इस गिलास रॉड को मैं लाइटर या पीस ऑफ पेपर के नजदीक या पिच बॉल के साथ टच कर दूं, तो यू विल नॉट सी एनी अट्रैक्शन और रिपल्शन। सो वंस द बॉडी इज इलेक्ट्रीफाइड एंड हैविंग द अपोजिट पोलैरिटी, लोगों की पोलैरिटी कैसी, अपोजिट, गिलास रॉड कैसा लिया है, पॉजिटिव था, सिल्क क्लॉथ नेगेटिव। नाउ आई विल से बोथ द बॉडीज आर इलेक्ट्रीफाइड, एक के प्लस थ्री जैसा, एक के माइनस थ्री। Now I am touching them. Touching them मतलब charging by conduction है। Charging by conduction में क्या था? एक uncharged था और एक charged था। ये तो दोनों charge को touch करके रहा। We will see. अभी हम उसमें नहीं जाते ऐसा कैसे हुआ? But you will see the transfer of electron will take place. जो भी कहानी है इस chapter में, जो भी कहानी है, वो सब electrons की वजह से ही है। ये इलेक्ट्रॉन ही है जो ट्रांसफर होगा फ्रॉम वन बॉडी टू अनदर। प्रोटॉन कैन नॉट बी ट्रांसफर फ्रॉम वन बॉडी टू अनदर, वी विल डिस्कस टुमारो और इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर। सो जो कहानी है वो इलेक्ट्रॉन्स की। सो व्हेन आई टच अ सिल्क क्लॉथ विद अ ग्लास रॉड, इलेक्ट्रॉन विल बी ट्रांसफर एंड द इफेक्ट विल मैग्निफाई। अब ग्लास रॉड न्यूट्रल हो जाएगा पहले की तरह, सिल्क क्लॉथ वो भी न्यूट्रल हो जाएगा। अब इस गिलास रॉड को तुम पिच बॉल के साथ टच कर दो, तो ये पिच बॉल में ना अट्रैक्शन होगा ना रिपल्शन, इवन देयर विल नॉट बी एनी अट्रैक्शन और रिपल्शन बिटवीन द टू सब्सटेंस, ये न्यूट्रल हो गए जैसे पहले थे। सो दे नलिफाई द इफेक्ट एंड सो बेंजामिन फ्रैंकलिन ने the charges as positive charge and negative charge, because when equal number of positive charge and negative charge come in contact with each other, they nullify their effect. And conventionally, the proton is named, yeah, we say the proton is positive charge particle. So proton is a positively charged particle and electron is negative charge particle. So conventionally proton को positive charge बोला गया, electron को negative charge बोला गया। Now ये जो branch पढ़ रहे हैं, मैंने पहले बोला कौन सी branch पढ़ रहे हैं, static electricity। उस समय इलेक्ट्रॉन की डिस्कवरी नहीं हुई थी, द ब्रांच इज वेरी वेरी ओल्ड ब्रांच, अबाउट 1600 बीसी, नॉट एन एग्जैक्ट ईयर आई नो, बट इट इज अ ओल्ड ब्रांच। उस समय इलेक्ट्रॉन्स के बारे में ज्यादा नॉलेज नहीं था, लेकिन कन्वेंशनली प्रोटॉन को बाद में पॉजिटिव चार्ज पार्टिकल बोला, इलेक्ट्रॉन को नेगेटिव चार्ज पार्टिकल, और अब दोनों लेटर ऑन इक्वल फॉर्म, बोथ आर इक्वल इन मैग्नीट्यूड एंड अपोजिट इन डायरेक्शन, और चार्ज की वैल्यू, इन दोनों के चार्ज का मैग्नीट्यूड जो कि तुमने छोटी क्लास में पढ़ा है 10th में, द वैल्यू इज 1.6 into 10 is to minus 19 coulomb, इसका भी discussion करेंगे। So if it is a proton, एक proton का charge plus 1.6 into 10 is to minus 19 coulomb, एक electron का charge because electron is negatively charged, it is -1.6 nanocoulomb. So magnitude is same, but direction we will see they are oppositely charged. अब इन दोनों का summation करूँगा तो real number जैसे zero answer आएगा. और इसलिए बेंजामिन फ्रैंकलिन ने एक को पॉजिटिव बोल दिया, एक को नेगेटिव. एनीवे फिजिक्स को कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ता है. इफ आई इंटरचेंज द कन्वेंशन, दिस इज द कन्वेंशन वी हैव टू फॉलो एंड वी आर फॉलोइंग, बट इट मेक्स नो डिफरेंस इफ आई चेंज द कन्वेंशन. ज्यादा से ज्यादा फर्क किसका पड़ेगा, प्लस माइनस साइन का फर्क पड़ेगा. सो बेंजामिन फ्रैंकलिन गेव द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ पॉजिटिव एंड नेगेटिव चार्ज. हिस्टोरिकली स्टैटिक इलेक्ट्रिसिटी का ओरिजिनेशन थेल्स ऑफ मिलेटस को जाता है, जो ग्रीक का साइंटिस्ट था. एंड वी हैव सीन द डिफरेंट सब्सटेंस व्हेन रब्ड विद ईच अदर आर चार्ज. सिमिलरली व्हेन द टू चार्ज सब्सटेंस आर केप्ट इन कांटेक्ट विद ईच अदर, दे नलिफाई द इफेक्ट, और यू कैन से दे लूज द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ अट्रैक्टिंग द लाइटर ऑब्जेक्ट्स. So this is what we have in the introductory part of chapter 1. In the next lecture, we will see how glass rod becomes positive charge, or why the silk cloth becomes negative charge, why there is a force of attraction, repulsion, what is electric force, and most important, still I have not defined what is electric charge. ये तो मैंने अभी तक define ही नहीं किया. यहां पहुंच गया, दो टाइप का चार्ज होता है, पॉजिटिव चार्ज नेगेटिव चार्ज. पर अभी हमें पता नहीं है चार्ज है ही क्या. सो वी डिस्कस द ऑब्जर्वेशन, देयर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ चार्ज, पॉजिटिव चार्ज नेगेटिव चार्ज. अनलाइक चार्ज, सो पॉजिटिव नेगेटिव चार्ज विल अट्रैक्ट. लाइक चार्ज, पॉजिटिव पॉजिटिव विल रिपल, नेगेटिव नेगेटिव विल रिपल. एंड इफ पॉजिटिव एंड नेगेटिव आर केप्ट इन कॉन्टेक्ट विद ईच अदर, द रिजल्टेंट इज न्यूट्रल. And they will not attract each other. So this is the end of the first lecture of chapter 1.